What's up, guys? I'm Ashley Jenkins, and before the weekend begins, you should know that Nintendo has published a 1.1 patch for Pokemon X and Y that fixes the save corruption in Lumio City and restores currently corrupted saves. It also addresses a rare issue that crashed the game when trading Pokemon in the Global Trade Station. The patch is available to both physical and digital versions of the game and takes up 229 blocks of memory on your SD card. Just load up the eShop and it should notify you that the update is available for your game, then prompts you to download. On the off chance it doesn't, you can always locate the update in the Pokemon X and Y catalog item. Rockstar is also working on yet another GTA 5 title update to solve additional issues they've identified with GTA Online before distributing their stimulus package, which was initially planned to go out this week. They plan to release that update next week and then make it rain GTA bucks. The big concern, of course, is that they don't want to distribute money, then have players encounter the progress issues and lose the money that's an apology for those exact problems. Makes sense, right? Well, if it helps, they're also working on a ton of new content. Early next month, they'll release their first free content add-on, the Beach Bum Pack. It'll add beach-themed vehicles and weaponry, new character customization options, a new set of gang attack, survival, last team standing, parachute, deathmatch, and race jobs. They're also working on the content creator, which will launch with packs that enable players to create races and deathmatches, though they don't have an exact date for that yet. The best user-created content will get verified tags and feature placement on their site. Additional details should be available next week, and they'll also share more about their heist and capture the flag modes then. And games aren't the only things getting updates. Sony announced today that the PlayStation 4 will have a day one update that adds, well, pretty much all the functionality they've talked about over the last few months. The update, which will be about 300 megabytes, adds remote play and second screen functionality, adds the video encoding and uploading system for game video and screenshot capture, enables live stream broadcasting via Ustream and Twitch, adds the Play As You Download feature, which will allow you to start playing a digitally purchased game while it's still downloading, enables multiple users to log into the console at a time, adds 8-player party chat, face recognition, voice command options, enables online multiplayer, adds background music options via Music Unlimited, and activates the Blu-ray and DVD player. What it won't include is sleep mode, which won't be available right at launch. It will come sometime later. It's also worth noting that even if you don't install this update, you must connect to the internet to activate the Blu-ray and DVD player. Finally, BioShock Infinite's Burial at Sea Episode 1 has finally got a release date, and it's not far off. The new story-based content will be available for PS3, Xbox 360, and PC November 12th, and will be $14.99 standalone or free if you've got the season pass. The content adds new weapons and a new plasmid called Old Man Winter, and drops you into the shoes of a rapture-based booker who is approached by Elizabeth on the eve of the city's plunge into chaos to look for a missing girl. The first hour of the content won't involve any combat whatsoever. Instead, you'll explore the underwater city at the height of its glory and sniff out clues to the case. Then, of course, the shooting starts. The second episode, planned for early next year, will let you view the world through Elizabeth's eyes for the first time. And that's the news. Are you anxiously downloading the Pokemon update? How do you feel about GTA's upcoming content drop? Are you planning to connect your PlayStation 4 to the internet, or has this day one update convinced you to? And how excited are you to return to Rapture? Let us know in the comments below. Then visit roosterteeth.com, where Michael is grilling Gus and Bernie about their expansive Pokemon knowledge. And a new episode of The Gauntlet is airing this Sunday.